Hi, I'm Brian Trenchard-Smith. This is Trailers from Hell. Director Jun Bong-ho is best known for his offbeat monster movie, The Host. Visual effects are also a strong element in Snowpiercer, which he shot in glorious 35mm on elaborate sets at a green screen stage in the Czech Republic. The story is set entirely on a train, requiring all the carriages to be mounted on gimbals and rocked to give the actors the authentic feeling of a train in motion. A few years ago, Jun Bong-ho was browsing in a comic book store in Seoul and came across a 1982 French graphic novel, Le Transpierce-Neige. He picked it up and read it cover to cover while still standing. His movie version became a solid hit across the world, grossing its $40 million budget in Korea alone. I think it's fantastic. Here's the premise. Cloud seeding has caused the world not to flourish, but to freeze. A prescient industrialist has created a perpetual motion railway vehicle, hermetically sealed and self-sustaining, on which mankind's survivors live in a rigidly controlled hierarchy. The poor in the rear carriages fed protein blocks of green jello, while the ruling oligarchs near the engine have all the luxury goods they enjoyed before. It's a politically provocative class warfare parable. A Titanic on wheels, indicting both capitalism and communism, with some bleak observations on how society is really controlled. I like the way a religious mythology has been created as a social control mechanism. The engine of the train has been deified. It is holy and all-knowing. So obey and hug your rut. Captain America's Chris Evans does well as the reluctant rebel leader. I thought his final monologue, a challenge given its content, was a great piece of acting. He heads a multi-ethnic cast, Korean star Song Kang-ho, Academy Award winner Octavia Spencer, and John Hurt, whose character, Gilliam, is a nod to Terry Gilliam's Brazil, another socio-political allegory. All the actors shine, but it is Tilda Swinton who steals the movie as the scornful mouthpiece of the elite. A buck-toothed, goggle-eyed version of Margaret Thatcher. The Weinstein Company wanted to cut 20 minutes. As Dune reports it, eliminating nuance and adding narration to ensure that the film could be understood in Iowa. Happily, they were talked out of it. Dune's smarter version prevailed. For me, Snowpiercer is one of the top 10 dystopian movies of all time. After dynamic action scenes and stunning visuals, it leaves you thinking. Check it out.
I know what people taste like. I know that babies taste best.